Hello everyone, welcome to my video. Today, the topic is about how to keep your account safe. The reason I'm bringing this up is because most of Japanese mobile games don't link to Facebook account. So if you happen to break your phone, or the maintenance screw up, or the server actually down, you're most likely saying goodbye to your account. The purpose of this video is not to let any of that happen. Using my own experience, I have breaking this video into different parts. So if you would like to skip to a specific part, please use the annotation I put up in this video. So, what would keep my account safe? In this game, you could use what I call a one-time code and password. These two will let you to access and use an account that both link to. They are one-time because once you use them, the code and password will no longer work. So if you want to access this account again because of whatever accident, you need to make sure that you have set them up beforehand. This could help you to transfer your account from one mobile device to another, and again, once the transfer is finished, both the code and password are no longer usable. So, where can you get this one-time code and password that I am talking about? In order to set these up, go to the menu and click on this option. Go down all the way until you see this second last button. I would recommend to try to remember the letters as they may change the order of these buttons in the future. When you are in, do what you will see. Here is where you set up your password. The first box is the password itself. The second box is to confirm the password. Now, let's try to complete both. You will get a message like this after entering the password. Just click on the right button. Just a tip for you though, every time you see a message like this, it means the game is asking you for confirmation. The yes or the confirm button is always on the right, while the no or the cancel button is on the left. Oops, getting some connection error. Now you will get something like this. This is the code. You can click on the button next to the code to copy it to somewhere else, which you should do. This code and the password earlier should be kept in somewhere safe. I usually save them in my phone as well as my laptop, but it's all up to you. What I will do now is to log in the account I used earlier instead of starting a new game. How do I know that in front of me is a new game? If there is an account, you will see your friend code displays in the middle of the screen. But in this case, it doesn't. To log into the earlier account, instead of touching the screen in the middle, you need to touch the button at the bottom left. All you have to do is to accept and enter what you set up earlier in these boxes. The top box is the code, the below is the password. Now, let's start typing in the code and the password that we set up earlier. Oops, sorry guys, my cap lock. Okay, if everything is correct, you will get this message. Click on the button in the middle, it will take you back to the title screen. And now you will see the friend code display in the middle of the screen. And here we go, back to the account that we just used earlier. Now I am able to access this account. I will immediately set up new code and password because I don't know when the server is going down or my phone just suddenly stopped working. Simply just follow what we had been doing earlier. Keep in mind that you can enter the same password, but because the ID is auto-generated, it will be different every time the new password is created. And guys, that's all I got for now. For any question or idea for the next video, please put a comment below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you find this video helpful, please like, and even better, subscribe to my channel for more videos in the future. Take care and bye for now.